Hi everyone, welcome to another Yarn Scrap Friday, and this week I'm going to be showing you how to make this mini poinsettia. And to make this mini poinsettia, we're going to be using two colours, red and some green, and I'm going to be using a DK light worsted weight yarn. This is a yarn weight of 3. And we're going to be using a 3mm crochet hook, and you're going to need a yarn needle and a pair of scissors as well. But you can of course use any yarn that you like and any hook, crochet hook, that's suitable for the yarn that you're using. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our green. Right there, let's take our green yarn. And we're going to chain 4 to begin. So let's chain 4 to begin. Okay. And this pattern is in US terminology. Chain 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's chain 4. And we're going to put our hook in our first chain to form a loop. So do a slip stitch, bring the yarn through that first chain, then straight through the loop on your hook. And that creates a little loop of your chains that are joined at the beginning and the end. And in the middle, you should see a little tiny hole, and into that hole we need to work 6 single crochet. So I'm going to put my hook in the middle and through the loop, and ignoring how many chains you got now, we're just going to bring the yarn through and do a single crochet as normal. And we need 6 of these, and there's 1 back into the center. So I'm just literally going through the middle of that loop. 2, the middle again, 3, four, 5, and the last one, 6. So I'm just literally wrapping those single crochet around the chains. And then what we're going to do is we are going to do a slip stitch in our first single crochet. So you should have 6 single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And put your hook into that first single crochet and do a slip stitch. So bring the yarn through the stitch, then straight for the loop on your hook to join the round. And you can pull the centre hole closed a little bit. And there we go, you should have something that looks like that. You should still have 6 stitches. Then what we're going to do is we're going to chain 4. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. We're going to chain 4. Then we're going to slip stitch in the next stitch, but only in the front loop. So what you want to do is, that was one we just slip stitched into. So in the next stitch here, normally we would go under 2 bits of yarn like that, but we just want to go under the front one, so like that. So just come through the middle, so that's the front loop, and then we're going to do a slip stitch in there. So bring that through that front loop, then straight through the loop on your hook like so, and we're just going to repeat that all the way round. So we're going to chain 4 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, chain 4 again, then find your next stitch, and instead of putting it through both loops, underneath both loops, we're going to put it under that first one only. That's our front loop. Bring the yarn through there, then straight through the loop on your hook to do a slip stitch. Okay, and repeat it again. Chain 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then find the next front loop. Like so. Do a slip stitch. And then the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then find the next stitch, and then just under that front loop only, just that one, we do a slip stitch. And then again, 1, 2, 3, 4, find the next stitch, next front loop, and then do a slip stitch, and then we do it once more because we need to get 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and then find that very last one there, which is the beginning of the round. Do a slip stitch, like so. You should have something that looks like that, which is like almost like a tiny mini little flower, which is cute in itself. And that creates the center piece there, but we've only worked into the front loops, leaving these back loops to work the petals. So then what we're going to do is we're going to join our red. So to do that, what we're going to do is you want to push your little petal forward. Well, if you turn it over, you should see if I cut this tail down, then that shows you on the back, you should see the 6 stitches still, which are the back loops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So what we want to do is finding that next one, which is going to be that one there. These are the back loops that we didn't work into. So put your hook into that back loop, that first back loop, and then we're going to join our red. So we're going to get our red. Okay, so in that back loop, just drape the red over and bring that through that back loop and then straight through the loop on there. So you do a little slip stitch and now you're working with the red. Okay, so then what we're going to do is we're going to chain 2, 1 and 2. We're going to count that as a double crochet. Then what we need to do is a double crochet in the same back loop that we've just brought that red through. So we yarn over and go back into that same back loop there and do a double crochet. So bring that through that back loop and do a double crochet. So effectively you've got an increase there of 2 double crochets, because we're counting those chain 2 as a double crochet. You can pull your tail ends tight if you want to. And we're going to do 2 double crochet in each back loop around. So find your next back loop there, put your hook into there, and do 2 double crochet in there. There's one, and then go into it again and do another. So you've got 2 in there. Okay, 2 double crochet in there. Then we need to do 2 double crochet in the next back loop. So find that next back loop that you skipped. Do 2 double crochet in there. 1 and 2. Okay. Then the next one. Next back loop, which is there. Do 2 double crochet in there. 1 and 2. And the next one. 2 double crochet in there. 1 and another 1, 2. And then the very last back loop. I think this is our last back loop. This will count at the end, make sure. Hook in there, do 2 double crochet in there. 1 and 2. Okay, and if to make sure we're at the end, all we need to do is count how many stitches. We should have 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and then those top of our 2 chain equals 12. So we're at the end. So what we need to do now is we need to just slip stitch into that top of our 2 chain. So moving this green out of the way, find the top of your 2 chain. There's a first chain, there's a second. You hook in there and do a little slip stitch. like so. So you should have something that looks a little bit like that. Okay. Okay, so now what we're going to do is I'm just going to trim this green off. Because we finished with that, and that will stop you, or stop me and you getting tangled up. So now we're going to start working on the leaves. And when we work the leaves, we're actually working the left side of the leaves first, or petals rather. Working the left side first around, and then we work the right side around. So all shall become clear. But all we do is we're going to chain nine. Now, so chain nine, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So chain nine. And we're going to do one single crochet in our second stitch from hook. So our second stitch from hook, we don't count the loop on a hook. There's our first stitch, there's our second. So put the hook in there and do a single crochet. Then we're going to do a single crochet in the next chain as well. Like so. And then we are going to do a half double crochet in the next stitch. So yarn over, go into the next chain and do a half double crochet. Okay. Then we're going to do a double crochet in the next stitch. Double crochet. Then we're going to do a treble crochet in the next two. So treble crochet, we yarn over twice, go into the next chain, bring the yarn through. Then we yarn over, pull through the first two loops, two, three left, yarn over, pull for the next two loops left, yarn over, pull for the last two to do a treble. We do another one of those in the next stitch. So yarn over twice, go into the next stitch, and yarn through. So you've got four loops. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two to do another treble. So you've done one treble in the next two, and then we're going to do a double crochet in the next stitch. So double crochet in the next stitch. And then we're going to finish up with a half double crochet in the next stitch. So you should have one chain left. In that last chain, we're going to do a half double crochet. Like so. Then what we're going to do is we are going to do a slip stitch in the next stitch on the main circle, red circles. So find the next stitch along. So that was the one we slip stitched into. So find that next stitch, going through both loops as normal. And do a slip stitch in there. And then in the next stitch as well, we're going to do a slip stitch as well. So just pull it through the stitch and then straight for the loop on the hook. So you've done two slip stitches, you've done one slip stitch in the next two on the main circle. And then we just repeat the same thing again. This half, you can see that's the left side of the petal. Then we'll do the other side after. So let's do the next one. We'll chain nine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then we do a single crochet in our second stitch from hook, so don't count the loop on your hook. There's the first stitch, there's the second, and in there we're doing a single crochet. Then a single crochet in the next stitch, then a half double crochet in the next stitch. Then a double crochet in the next stitch. And then we're going to do a treble crochet in the next stitch. So yarn over twice and stitch and pull through two, pull through two, pull through two to do a treble. Then a treble crochet in the next stitch. And if you're new to crocheting, it might be worth you going back and mastering these stitches and then coming back to this video if you're struggling to keep up. Then we're going to do a double crochet in the next stitch. And then we're going to finish up in the last chain with a half double crochet. Like so. And then we do the same as we did before. Find the next stitch on the main circle and do a slip stitch. and then we do a slip stitch in the next stitch as well. Okay, and there's your second half of a petal. So just repeat that round until you get back to the beginning and you've got six of these half petals. Okay, so you just do the same thing again, chain nine. Okay, so I'm just coming up to the last stitch, half double crochet on the last petal, or half a petal. And then what we're going to do is we're going to slip stitch on the main circle just like we did before. And then we're back at the beginning. So slip stitch in the next one as well, regardless of round. So you should still do a slip stitch in the next two, even at the end. Okay, so you should have something that looks a little bit like that. It's quite curly at the moment. You just repeated doing the chain nine, working those stitches, slip stitching in the next two on the main circle. And now what we're going to do is we're going to work the other half of the petal. We're going to work the right side. So you should have finished up right in the corner there. And when working into your chains, it's a good idea to just work into the, go underneath one loop when working in your chains. For example, if I do some quick chains here, when working into your chains, just go under that one little bit of loop there rather than two loops or anything like that, because it means that you can still see the chains when we work back in them into them again for the right side. So what we're going to do now is we're going to mirror what we've done on the left side, on the right side. So we're going to start off with a half double crochet. So finding that chain, last chain that you worked into on this leaf, you're going to put your hook back into there just like that. And I've done a video in more detail of crocheting back into your chains, foundation chains. I'll put a link in the description to that video. But we're going to go back into that same chain where that half double crochet is at the bottom of your petal. So there's your half double crochet, and there's the chain that we worked into. So we're going to go back into there and do another half double crochet like so. And then the double crochet for the next one, I'm going to do a double crochet in there again as well. So there was the double crochet, and there was the chain that we worked it into. So we're going to go back into there again and do a double crochet to mirror it, like so. You can see the stitch better then. And the same for the next one, we did two trebles there, so we're going to do a treble in the next one, yarn over twice, there's the treble, and we're going to go into the same chain as that treble again and do another treble to mirror the other side. There's a treble. Then it was a treble for the next one as well. So there was the chain we worked that other treble into. Go back in there and do another treble. Pull through two, pull through two, pull through two. And then it was a double crochet. So we go back into the same chain as that double crochet and do another double crochet. Then it was a half double crochet there. So we do a half double crochet in that same chain there. And then we've got two single crochets. So there was the little single crochet. So we go back in there. If you can find it. There's one. And then we need to do a single crochet at the top as well. And if it's hard to find, just place your hook on the corner and just push through and it should find it by itself, and do a single crochet there. So you should end up with two single crochets at the end in those last two stitches. And there we go, that's a mirror image of this side with a half double crochet, double crochet, and you've got a treble, treble, double crochet, half double crochet, single crochet, single crochet. And now what we need to do is to get back to the base to do the next one. So to do that, we're going to do slip stitches in these stitches down this left side of this petal. So find that first stitch on the left side and do a little slip stitch. And we're just going to slip stitch all the way down back to the base, down this left side. Each stitch down. pushing these out of the way. We've got one more and then we're back to base, like so. And then what we need to do is in the middle along here, we just need to do a little slip stitch. You should see a little, see there with the two slip stitches you did on the previous round. In those, you just want to do a slip stitch on top of those. So one and the next one, two. Remember, if you did those two slip stitches on the base, we just want to go back into those two again and do slip stitches on top of them. And then that brings us to the next petal. So we do the same again. We start off with a half double crochet. Find that half double crochet, which is there, going across. And there's the chain it goes into. So put your hook back in there and do a half double crochet. And then the next one's a double crochet. Find that chain it's gone into. There it is. Double crochet. And then a treble. There's the treble. There's the chain it's gone into. Two, the treble for the next one. There's the chain it's gone into. Then it was a double crochet. Then a half double crochet. Then a single crochet, and then one more single crochet, which can be a little bit hard to find, so we're just going to put a hook on the corner and push. It should find it. And there we go, and we're back at the top again. We've done the right side. So again, slip stitch back down to base, down into these stitches. Slip stitches. Let's move these out of the way. Almost there. And then that should bring you back to those slip stitches that you did on the previous round. There we go. So there were the two slip stitches. There's the first one, it's the second. So in there, we want to do slip stitches on top of those as well, just to get us over to the next petal. And then we're back again at the next petal. And you just need to repeat that method for each of the petals around the flower, just working back into these chains up the right-hand side, mirroring these stitches with the half double crochet, the two trebles, double, half, double crochet, and then the two single crochet. Slip stitch down the edge, slip stitch in the two previous slip stitches all the way, and just repeat that round for the remaining petals until you're back at the beginning. So I shall do that and I shall come back and show you. Right, next thing to do is find that half double crochet, find the chain that it went into. There we go. Okay, so I'm just finishing up the last petal, slip stitching down the left side back to the base. And then when I'm back here, just going to, where's the leaf gone? There we go. Find those slip stitches and just slip stitch on those, and then I'm back to the very very first petal that we did. So we can cut our yarn, pull up through, and there we go, there is our finished mini poinsettia. And you may want to create additional bigger leaves to go behind if you want to. I'm going to stop there and just make this as a little simple gift wrap flower and sew these tail ends to the back. And you can either sew these tail ends in and hide them, or you can keep them for sewing onto, for tying onto gift wrap. I've kept the red ones on this one, so then I can just use that to tie onto a present or onto some ribbon or something. So there we go. So I hope you enjoyed that tutorial. Hope you managed to follow along. A little bit fiddly. Like I said, if you're new to these stitches and you're new to basically crocheting in general, then I do recommend checking out my beginner tutorials and then coming back to this video. I will put a link in the description to the video that I did in more detail on crocheting into your foundation stitches, which might help. But I hope you enjoyed that, and I think that's about it. So I shall see you soon for some more crochet fun. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.